Welcome children. In the last class, we discussed about meristematic tissue in detail. So, what is meant by meristematic tissue? Meristematic tissue is nothing but which gives overall growth and repair to the plant body. So, all the other three tissues, dermal tissue, ground tissue, vascular tissue, all the other three tissues derived from the meristematic tissue. Now, we will discuss in detail about the dermal tissue, ground tissue, vascular tissue. Now, coming to the dermal tissue. So, here the dermal tissue is present in overall surface of all parts of the body. So, in each and every part of the plant on their surfaces, will observe the dermal tissue. So, based on the location, function, we'll see the three types of dermal tissue. So, here, the tissue which is present in the outermost layer, then we call it as the epidermis. If it is present in the middle layer, then we call it as the mesodermis. Still it is present in the innermost layers, then we call it as the endodermis. So, whenever we discussed the meristematic tissue, at that time we discussed that here the meristematic tissue, the cells are very small and the servo is very thin. But whereas in the dermal tissue, the cells are very large and the servo is very thick. Why the servo is very thick? So here, in order to protect the inner parts of the plant, here the servo is very thick, which in order to protect the inner parts of the plant, and it also protects the plant by the parasitic invasion. So here the epidermis is the single layer. So here the dermal tissue is the single layer. If we observe the dermal tissue in the under the microscope, then we observe a small pore which we call it as the stomata. So the small pore-like structure which we observe in the dermal tissue is the stomata. So here the stomata is surrounded by the two God cells. The stomata is surrounded by the two God cells. So here we'll observe the hair-like projections which arise from the stomata is called the root hairs. So the function of the stomata is the gaseous exchange and it also helps for the transpiration. Next, coming to the ground tissue. So here the dermal tissue present in overall the surface of the body, whereas this ground tissue gives the bulk of the plant body. That means bulk means in more amount, we'll see the ground tissue in the plant body. So here, we'll find the three types of tissues in the ground tissue. So, parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. If you see the structure of the parenchyma, so here the cells are large and here we will find the intercellular spaces and the cell wall is very thin. If you see the collenchyma, so here the cells are long, but here there is a thick arrangement in the collenchyma. If you see the sclerenchyma, so here in sclerenchyma, when compared with the colenchyma, still more thickly closed here. So here the, we can see the tight arrangement in the cell, which gives the protection to the inner parts of the plant. So again here the parenchyma is divided into three types, that is chlorenchyma, aerenchyma, storage tissue. So coming to the chlorenchyma, so some of the parenchyma cells consists of the chloroplast, which we call it as the chlorenchyma. So next, coming to the aerenchyma. So here, some of the parenchyma cells consists of the air cavities present in the hydrophytes. That means the plants which live in the water are called as the hydrophytes. So we'll observe the aerenchyma tissue in the water plants. Next, coming to the storage tissue. Some of the parenchyma cells have the capacity to store the food and the waste materials. So it is called as the storage tissue. So next, coming to the dermal tissue. Here the dermal tissue have one more feature. That means here the dermal tissue in the xerophytes, that means the plants which live in the deserts, are called as the xerophytes. So here the xerophytes have the still more thick dermal tissue in order to protect the inner parts of the plant from the hot. So vascular tissue. So the other name for the vascular tissue is the conductive tissue. This vascular tissue is also derived from the meristematic tissue. So here the vascular tissue consists of the two types of tissues known as xylem and phloem. So the xylem and phloem together called as the vascular bundle. So here, why we call it as the conductive tissue? Here it helps for the transportation of the food and water to different parts of the plant body. So the xylem helps for the transportation of water to different parts of the plant, whereas the phloem helps for the transportation of the food to different parts of the plant. So here this is the structure of the tails of dicot stem, where we can able to see the structure of the vascular bundle. So here the uppermost layer is the cuticle, which helps to protect the inner parts of the plant. So here epidermis. So it is the one of the part of the dermal tissue. So here it is the chlorenchyma, which is the ground tissue. So here it is the endodermis. Endodermis is also a part of the dermal tissue. So here this is the xylem and phloem. So in each and every part of the plant, all the four tissues are present. Next, coming to the xylem. So if you take the example of the eucalyptus, so the height of the eucalyptus is 200 feet. So here the xylem has the capacity to transport the water to that much height. Then coming to the red sandal trees. So here the xylem helps to transport the water to 320 feet of the red sandal. So it is the specialty of the xylem. Next, coming to the scientist Nehemiah group. So he was the one of the physician who kept his research on the anatomy of the plants. So what is meant by anatomy? Anatomy is nothing but the branch of science which deals about the internal structure of the plant. So here Nehemiah group kept his research on the internal structure of the plant. So he worked in the Royal Society, which is located in the London. So
what Nehemiah grew said. So he said that every part, if the fundamental part of the plant consists of the two parts known as the pithy part and ligneous part. And he gave the new terms to the pithy part called as the parenchyma. So, in this lesson, we studied the four different types of tissues present in the plant. The first one is the meristematic tissue, which gives the overall growth and repair to the plant. The second one is the dermal tissue, which is present in almost all surfaces of the plant. The next one is the ground tissue, which gives the bulk of the plant body. And the last but not the least is the vascular tissue, which helps for the transportation of the food and water to different parts of the plant. So, once again, let us see the vascular tissue. So, here the xylem consists of the vessels, tracheas and fibers. So, these are the different parts present in the xylem. Then coming to the phloem, so the phloem consists of the companion cells, sieve cells and sieve tubes. So the both the xylem and phloem together called as the vascular tissue. So these are the different cells of the xylem and phloem, which helps for the transportation of the food and water in the plant.